Our little teddy is now dry and ready for painting. Before we get started painting anything, I'm going to paint with acrylic paint, which is plastic paint. It will wash off your hands and your tables eventually, but if you get the acrylic paint on your clothes, it can ruin your clothes or permanently stain them. So what I've done is it's very easy to make a little clothes protector for your students. This is just a garbage bag. It's upside down. And I've cut a little head hole in there, little arm holes, and you can slide that over the little bodies. And if your students have bigger bodies, you can just get a bigger bag. Anyway, so our clothes are protected. I have my apron. We're going to get ready to paint the teddy. Before we get ready to paint, I'm going to talk about the paint itself. This is just acrylic paint. It's the cheap dollar store paint. The cheaper, the better. It's even more cost effective if you buy bigger containers, then you can pour it into the cups and pour it back. If you buy a big container and it gets a little bit old and starts to thicken up a bit, add a bit of water, shake it up, stir it up. You can make your paint last for a year or more. Anyway, so we have our paint ready. We're going to need the little containers. Any little container that doesn't leak is a great container for holding your paint. I have a couple of brushes. I like to use two sizes. I like a big one for big painting and a little one for a little decorating painting. And paper towel. As I said, it will stain. It does wash off, but there's no reason to leave it dry on there anyway. Okay, we're going to start painting our teddy. I'm going to use the big brush. And I'm just going to start painting the bottom. And the paint, I like to paint the bottom first. You want to apply a liberal coat. Put lots of paint on there. And notice I'm painting the bottom and I'm getting it on the table, but it will wash off. And I'm going to paint all on the bottom. And then I'm going to paint up the sides as much as I can. And I'm putting it on thick. As I said, this paint is inexpensive. Now, as you're painting this, you'll notice that the surface is not dry or dusty. If there's any dust on it, it will be completely covered and sealed by the acrylic paint. Now this is kind of wet, so we're going to get this far. I'm just going to lay it on the paper and it will dry. I'll come back when it's dry. Well, that was fun. It was kind of like watching paint dry. Our teddy is dry now. His paint has gone from shiny to flat. And speaking of dry, you can tell when your teddy's ready to paint because the clay will go from dark clay to light clay. And if you put your teddy on your face and if it's still a bit cool or feels cold to the touch, it's not quite dry, give it a day or two longer to dry, but put it to your face before you start painting and not after. Anyway, so he's dry and I'm going to start painting him now. Now this is the base color. I'm going to paint every little bit of that teddy I can. I'm going to cover the entire clay with paint, inside, outside, in, around, and underneath. Make sure the entire surface is completely sealed with the acrylic paint. I'm going to paint his little armpits and paint his little neck. And just make sure, see in there, I've missed those. Make sure you don't. When you're helping your students paint these, make sure you go along. Quite often students will only paint the front and forget about the back. But upside down, sideways, all around the town, your teddy has to be completely covered in the brown paint. And then when it's completely covered in the brown paint, I'm going to let it dry again, which would be more watching paint dry. And then I'm going to come back and decorate the teddy. But at this point, if you wanted to, you could leave the teddy sealed. You can leave it one color. Decorating is entirely up to you. I like to decorate the teddy, but he's completely sealed in the paint, making sure that even in these little decorations there's paint. It just looks nicer to have none of the gray clay showing. So now he's completely saturated, covered, and a brown teddy. This will take about 10 or 15 minutes to watch paint dry. I'll come back and we'll decorate. Well, I got tired of standing here watching paint dry, so I thought I'd go find some projects that are already finished and just talk a little bit about the finished product. This process makes a very durable, great piece. It's been said on someone's website once that you couldn't do this with regular clay, that the finished product was very dusty. Well, this isn't very dusty, and easily broken. We've had these projects for, I don't know, well, Amber here, and we made this is our lovely granddaughter, Amber. And we made this picture frame. She was 9 or 10, and now she's 16. The picture frame is doing just fine. Everything in, if you follow the rules, like I said, it's as thick as a finger. The pieces are wet and wiggled, and it sticks together. And now this little piece here, I did say little pieces like to break. Well, this is just a little bit of a toothpick for antenna, because a little piece that small of clay will break. But they are a durable product. You can keep them for as long as you like. They are not kitchen safe, however, but I'm not going to take it home and put a sandwich on it anyway. Anyway, my paint is dry, and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to decorate my teddy. Now, my little teddy is dry. I'm going to start painting. I'm going to paint in layers. So I've got the whole thing as brown. Now I'm going to start what I call painting out. I have a light brown here for his tummy and his toes. And in order to get light brown, all I did was add white to dark brown. You can mix acrylic paint colors, like oil paints. If you want pink, add white to red and you'll have pink. Anyway, play with the colors and you can have your own unique batch of colors. I just lighten that out a little bit. I'm going to give Teddy a light tummy. Now, I mentioned when we first started doing this that I used a big brush and a little brush. I'm going to use a little brush for little things. And notice when I'm painting, I don't have to go all the way to touch the tummy. And that's the nice way about painting in layers, because what happens is the students try to get in there, and then they touch, they get paint on the body, and then it just gets all messy. So just paint a little bit out. If you do get a little bit of paint on your teddy's body, you can just let it dry and paint it brown again. So I'm going to paint his tummy light brown. I'm going to paint his toes light brown. And these toes. Again, notice I'm just painting the top. I'm not painting around. And I'm going to paint his little ears in here light brown. And over here. And his little tail is going to be light brown. Again, not going all the way to the teddy's body and not going all the way to the platform he's sitting on. Okay, now as that dries, I can move on. I'm going to paint his eyes white because I want to paint them blue on top of that. So as his eyes dry, I can be painting something else. Now notice I'm going to paint the whole teddy's eye, not just the white part. And again, I'm not going all the way down to the teddy head, to the teddy heady, to the teddy's head. I'm only painting the top, so when I'm painting, it doesn't touch the rest of the paint. Now, I did get a little bit of paint on his body, on his face there. When it's dry, I'll paint it over brown or learn to live with not being perfect, whatever suits you. Okay, so now his eyes are going to dry, and I'm going to move on to the black paint. I'm going to paint his top hat black and his nose black. And again, you can see it's a good example of I'm not going all the way down to the teddy's head. I'm only going to paint the front because I want to. I'll paint the back later, but it gets a little boring watching me paint the back of a teddy's hat. But you can see the front, and then his nose is black. Now the last thing I'm going to do, now I've been painting that, his whites of his eyes should be dry. So I'm going to give Teddy blue eyes. Oh, Teddy blue eyes. And I'm just going to touch the very top of that with the blue. Now he's got bright blue teddy bear eyes. Now I know the back of his hat's not done, and I'll get to that later. The last thing I'm going to do is he sits there. I'm going to put Teddy on a little green platform. And you can take your time and get a bigger brush for this guy. On a little green platform, just a bit of water on that. And again, when you paint your platform, you don't have to go all the way to Teddy. You can pull back a bit because you can't really tell where the teddy ends and the platform starts. But if you get paint on your teddy, you can certainly tell that. Now I'm going to go ahead and we're going to paint the platform. I might even go and decorate the little textures. When we come back, his hat will be done, his platform will be done. He'll be textured and be ready for sealing. I finished painting our little teddy. I finished decorating his little platform. I thought some dots would be very nice. He's my teddy. I decorate him the way I like. Now I'm going to start sealing him, but before I seal him, I'm going to take a little second look just to make sure there isn't anywhere where the paint didn't get on. It looks messy if the gray clay shows through, and it will seal a lot better if it's completely covered in the paint. Now I would seal this the same way I would paint, by starting on the bottom, and when it's dry, turning it and painting the top up. I'm going to do it backwards today just because the cameras are here and you don't want to watch paint dry anymore, and neither do I. This is a triple thick. It's a DecoArt triple thick sealant, and we buy it and we thin it out three parts triple thick, easy for me to say, and one part water. It just makes it go a little bit further and it's a little bit easier to use. And I'm just going to paint it on with a big brush, and I'm going to paint it on just kind of like water. You don't want to work it a lot. It does sort of foam up a little bit. You want to make sure at this point your paint is completely dry, because if it isn't, it will run when you put the paint on. So just very quickly go over this guy, and it doesn't take very long. And again, you don't want to beat it up too much and froth it up, because it will get a little bubbly. In behind his ears, on his hat. And this is how you do all your projects. This is a very simple little teddy, and I did the same process on the simple teddy as you do it on any creation. Get your base color on, make sure the entire thing's covered with paint, paint in layers. Remember how I painted his eyes? The eyes were first brown, and then the eyes were white, and then on top of the white was the blue. Paint in layers, and you can decorate as little or as much as you like. One thing I'm going to add before we are done, if something happens to your teddy and his nose happens to fall off or a piece happens to fall off, acrylic paint is the best glue. All you want to do is put a drop of acrylic paint between the piece that fell off and where it fell off from. Let the paint dry, paint it up and seal it over, and it will work better than any glue you can ever buy. And basically that's it. That's our non-fired clay project is now done. It's durable, long-lasting. You can keep this teddy for as long as you like. It's cleanable. If your teddy sits around for years and gets dusty, we'll wash him with a damp cloth. But he is a shining example of why we like to say every day is clay day.